The evening, the food and the entertainment that's coming up. Tonight, you're supporting four different groups. The Roy F. Collier Community Center, the Martin County Historical Society, Shelton Clark's High School students under the teaching of Connie Harless, and their own Martin County talent. So I hope you all enjoy the evening, enjoy the food, and the entertainment will start after you all get finished eating. Right now, Phil Kirk is going to ask a blessing on the food and the event tonight.
Would you bow your heads with me, please? God, our Father in heaven, as we approach your throne of greatness at this time, Lord, we thank you for the bounty that you have given us in our lives, for the peace we have found through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. We ask, dear Lord, that you bless this event, that it can be successful, Lord, and that it will do the things that it was intended and meant to be. We just ask, Lord, that you bless everyone here and everyone's families. Watch over them and protect them, Lord, as you watch us every day. We ask that you bless the food that's going to be served this evening. We bless, ask your blessings upon those, the entertainers that are going to be performing this evening, Lord. And we just thank you so much for everything that you do. And for this community, Lord. We live in a wonderful community compared to other communities outside our area. And we just ask, Lord, your blessings upon our little community, the community of Inez, Warfield, and our county, that you would bless our citizens here, Lord, and that you watch over us and keep us safe, Lord. These things we ask through the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'd like to add one more thing. Connie Harless's students prepared the food, and they've worked yesterday and today, and you can show your appreciation by slipping something in a little envelope on the table that will go to Connie Harless's students. Thank you. Enjoy the evening.
Good evening, and welcome to the Community Center, but this song, well, first of all, this group kind of got together kind of as a funny, just a bunch of girls taking pictures and having a good time, and then we said we're all booked up and we don't take requests. Well, then someone asked us to do a benefit, and we realized we had to start singing, so that's how the group got together. But Rose is our main songwriter, and this particular song, we started writing songs about the community, the county, just different things, but this was motivated by the Historical Society and the fact that they're trying to do the restoration of the Himmlerville Mansion, and it really tells the story about it.
Brought the locals into the cold. simple place nestled in a valley. No one had ever taken interest in, but it would one day leave a mark in history because of what Martin Himmler did. Welcome to Himmlerville, a co-community in the fields. Everybody had a stake in the money that Black has brought in. The only place like this in a land of weather did exist. You'd never want to leave
story with a new pen.
You don't have to dance like
getting the banjo kick out.
Southbound train. Hey, 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 hey.
next song we're singing is dedicated to all of our mothers. It was a song that was written by the three of us, and hope you guys enjoy it. It's hard to sing sometimes, but we certainly think it's a good dedication to you and all of your mothers too.
This song is called Keeping the Circle Unbroken. She was always there to wipe my tears, calm me down in a moment of fear, gave me freedom but was always near, even as a child it was very clear. She couldn't fly.
Something that a lot of people can't remember before we had indoor plumbing. We had running water, but you had to go to the creek to get it. No, I'm just kidding. But this is about how we used to take a bath years ago. I hope you enjoy it. This is the first time I've tried to do it with the soundtrack, so we'll see how it goes. It was late on Saturday evening in a little country home. Mom was in the kitchen heating water on the stove. We all knew just what that meant. We're poor, but we're not dumb. It's time again for the weekly bath, and it would do no good to run. Them girls, they got to get in first, that water piping hot. You could see the steam arising when she poured that final pot. A brand new bar of ivory soap, just white as it could be. Them girls got in and they commenced to wash them dirty knees. It was a rousing tub full of cold gray water, a large bar of soap and a dirty brother. No need to be bashful or to worry about your pride, cause the whole world can see you when you bath outside. Anybody remember that? Before too long it was our turn, and Mom called out to me, You boys jump in now, get your bass, whilst you can still see. Well, we could see all right, and we could tell what them dirty girls had done. They'd left their dirt, their hair, their scum just floating in that tub. It was a rousing tub full of cold gray water, a large bar of soap and a dirty little brother. No need to be bashful or to worry about your pride, 'cause the whole world can see you when you back outside. Now everything is different, and it's something how things have changed. Well, I appreciate the memories and the way that I was raised. And some men say that you can't go back, and sometimes that really saddens me. But then I think about those weekly bass and them girls with dirty meat. It was a rousing tub full of cold gray water, a large bar of soap and a dirty little brother. No need to be bashful or to worry about your pride, 'cause the whole world can see you when you back outside.
And I am not apologizing.
Rainey Priest is one of the most talented, musically talented guys that I've ever been around. Like he just can come up with about anything musically, so I think he deserves another round of applause. Something's not right in the air around here, from the weather to my own heart's fear. The weatherman says we haven't seen this for years, and you have a cry, such bitter tears. Some things I thought were set in stone, like this ring on my finger that seems so alone. I guess things can change no matter how good it goes, and it's Tupelo, in Tupelo. It's Tupelo, in Tupelo, and my heart's just as cold. Never thought I'd feel a chill like this outside or in my soul. Gotta lay from the pain of letting go, 'cause love's left me in the cold, and it's too low, and too below. It's Tupelo, in Tupelo, in my heart just as cold. Never thought I'd feel a chill like this outside or in my soul. Got a layer up to protect myself from the pain of letting go, 'cause love's
me in the cold and it's too low, it's too below. Cause love's left me in the cold and it's too below,
in too below.
Char and Sandy and Rose, and I said, Char, you know, what's the temperature? Two below. And I just automatically said, two below and two below. So after that, Rose got busy and wrote a song. So that's how that one came about.
It's one of my favorites.
So. I love it.
About the streets.
Okay, this is another song, Come On Home to Martin County, that Rose wrote for us. And it was inspired by the dream team of Martin County. And we just felt like, you know, we needed a song to go with that. So, hope you enjoyed it.
And Sandy.
And Sandy, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Sandy's our song doctor. She's pretty much involved in that.
Gary Klein and Truman Ford is doing the background on this for us, so we wanted to see how you all here while we're singing.
We missed Truman.
We missed them.
Badly, but yeah. If you want to live where nature has its place, if you want to live where there's amazing grace, if you want to live by a creek or a tall oak tree, come on home to Martin County, come on home. Where we dream on. We dream about making our kids a better home. The hills we climb just make us strong. Come on home to Martin County, come on home. If you want to have a small town feel, if you want to enjoy a home cooked meal, if you want to gaze upon God's scene of free, come on home to Martin County, come on. About making our kids a better home. The hills we climb just make us strong. Come on home to Martin County, come on home. Where we dream.
Hope you enjoy.
We're going to have a drawing for the quick on the drawing. The group is a bluegrass band mostly, but their name is Farmhouse Band.
Thank you. Thank you.
lies there all along. They put a jug beside him and a barrel for his dog.
I like what Donna said when we come in tonight. We were talking about this is actually our first time as this group. But what we generally do at the farm, whoever shows up becomes the star. So Philip showed up tonight. Philip is our new star. Give him a hand. We started about an hour ago in the back. Philip is our star. Okay, Jim, let's show that.
Thank you.
jukebox playing. I turn about the wild side of life as I listen to the words you are saying. It brings memories when I was a trusting one.
As I went down to the river to pray.
crushing hopes that we cherish so dear. Clouds and storms will in time pass away. The sun again will shine bright and clear.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten your way. If you keep on the sunny side of
thank you.
We've got a brand new song that's probably 200 years old.
And we've sang it twice.
Has anybody here ever heard the old banjo tune? It's called Pretty Polly. It's a ballad. It is an old mountain ballad. Gary and Donna are going to sing us a story, and we're going to try to play it. And then we're going to get the banjo out.
What did he say? I went down to the jail. Well, hello everyone. My name's Randy Priest. I'm with Creekside Singers from Martin County, Kentucky. Tonight we're at the Roy F. Collier Community Center, raising money for the Historical Society. And sitting with me is Jared Goforth. Jared's a whale of a banjo player and a fiddle player, but he's got a lot of things going on in his life. And he's from Flutie Lick, Kentucky. East end of Martin County?
Yeah, right on the Tug River.
Okay. He's right on the Tug River. Jared's really handy. A lot of people tell him he was born about 200 years too late because of all of his interests that he has. So joining us now is Charles Mills. He's from the Mills Farm on Turkey Creek, Kentucky. And these guys, I'll let them talk to you and tell them about the animals that they have, and want Jared to tell about the cabin that he moved for about 15 miles away and rebuilt it. So Jared, if you would, just give us a brief history of how you got started, and tell us about your cabin.
Well, I started out interested in cabins about all my life, and I wanted to keep the heritage of it's from Martin County, and I bought it off the man, and it was his grandpa's, and he was the second sheriff of Martin County in 1882. And I said, I don't want to leave the county if he's going to sell it. So I bought it and rebuilt it, and making my family a home out of it. And I got three children, and I'm hoping that it'll be a home for them in the future. And we live on a little farm on Flutie Lick, and we raise hogs and chickens and horse and mule, and raise produce and sell at the farm market. And I do carpentry and handyman work ever since I've been in school. That's how I've made my living. And I build furniture and cane chairs and about anything with wood you need done.
How do we get a hold of it?
I got a Facebook, and you can get me on Facebook at Jared Goforth. And we got a YouTube channel now. It's called Flutie Lick Homestead, and we put all kinds of videos on the farm and around doing things and how we do things.
You have any hog killings?
Yeah, we kill a hog every year, and we kill Charles's hogs at my place, and we have a big community get together and we kill a hog.
Okay, Charles, why don't you tell us a little bit about your farm, and tell us a little bit about the September meeting that you have and how many people come in to enjoy that.
I guess maybe the farm that I own now is maybe one of the oldest working farms in this part of the country. It was settled about 1860 by my grandfather. He came in here, and it was a grant, I think, from maybe the government or something, and gave him a large portion of what's now known as Turkey Creek. And the farm laid dormant for about 40 years. And about 10 years ago, I decided to take it and renovate it. And I did. I went back. We took what we could save from the old archives. And we have some animals there. And it's become sort of a petting zoo. I hadn't thought about it at the start, but it's become a great place for children, parents to bring their children and just come in and spend the afternoon and maybe go hiking in the mountain.
Tell us what kind of animals you got up there.
We've got horses and cows and chickens and turkeys and dogs and cats. Just a few of each one, just enough so that kids will know a little bit about what it's all about. And Rainey said for me to tell you something about the September meeting. September meeting is known as the meeting on the hill. It is about, what, Rainey, 100 years old?
Yeah, 102, 103 years.
It brings people in from all over the country, our heritage, and it really goes deep. One visitor said to me sometimes back, says, it's almost like the Indians as far as the traditions. At my farm, the Labor Day weekend, it generally starts, the crowd starts coming like on a Thursday and generally leaves on the following Monday. But we will probably serve and entertain 200 or 300 relatives. It's kind of a continuous thing. It's not by invitation only. It's just open, and people just come. And it's a spiritual thing. It is. We have church at the church house on Saturday night, and on the mountain on Sunday morning. It's awesome. There will be several hundred people will gather at the cemetery and just have church. It's just wonderful.
Well, thank you, Charles. And I guess this will end our interview, and we appreciate you watching and hope you enjoyed the music. Thank you.